Dungaree family, Emily again with another little discussion. I spoke about mom guilt last time. This time I want to talk about self-love. It's a virtue that is being promoted so widely online these days, and I just see it everywhere, and it really got me thinking. The angle I want to take on this is self-love versus self-sacrifice. About the word self-love and the way it is preached really rings hollow to me. My first response, my instinctive response is, yes, I think it's important or good to take some time for yourself, buy yourself a chocolate, have some nice coffee, or read a book you enjoy, just, you know, shut off all your responsibilities for half an hour and just enjoy yourself. But the times that I've partaken in such activities of, you know, pure self-indulgence or just following my desires and neglecting those of the people who do rely on me for things, it hasn't been what I thought it would be or done for me what I thought it would do for me. I'm not saying I think it's entirely wrong. I just think the attitude or the way in which I was doing it was wrong, and it is due to this message that is being preached that we should do it for ourselves and it's going to do something amazing for us that nothing else can do for us. What happens when you indulge yourself is you're stimulating feel-good hormones, and by doing that more and more you become addicted to those experiences, because feeling good is just a feeling. And I know from experience that feelings come and go, and the more you chase them, the more empty it becomes. It's just an experience. A feeling should be connected to something meaningful and not just be chased for the sake of it. Through knowing that, I've had much more meaningful experiences because I'm not seeking to feel good all the time. So on the other end of the scale, we have self-sacrifice. And after thinking about it, I realized self-sacrifice is actually love. And from a Christian perspective, the greatest sacrifice and the greatest act of love was the most painful sacrifice ever made in world history. And that was Jesus Christ dying on the cross, sacrificing his life, his dignity, his name. Everything was lost in that moment, and no one appreciated what he was doing at the time. What I'm saying is that was a sacrifice, and it is equated to love. A lot of the time, real acts of love involve sacrifice, and it is actually inconveniencing you for the sake of someone else, to benefit someone else. I believe love and giving is really good for us. We are created to do things. We are created like we have hands, we have legs and feet, we have mouths and ears, like everything about us is function, to do things. To then say that, no, all of this is just about me. It's just so empty and sad. We are designed to be reciprocal creatures, to give and to take, to be in fellowship with people, and through giving, without any certain knowledge of how it's going to benefit you, it does benefit you. When I just indulge myself and just look out for myself, it comes very naturally to me, by the way. I'm always, in the smallest of ways, being self-preserving, looking out for myself, and giving myself what I want in the moment. It's a real struggle to make myself do things that it's not directly going to benefit me right now. And I think it's pretty human. When I just indulge myself, just look out for myself, I feel underapplied, I feel empty, I feel like I'm missing something. And the times where I know I am giving and I'm benefiting others in a meaningful way, I feel fulfilled, I feel at peace, I don't have my conscience bugging me. My life is rich and full, and I'm content. That is why I wanted to address self-love, because I'm concerned about the emptiness that people are going to be experiencing in pursuing themselves, and also because the fulfillment evades them, they will pursue it even harder. I hope that this speaks to some of you out there. It's when I say give yourself, I do mean it has to be logical and sensible. It's not as if you must lose yourself in charity work. You can do that, but if you already have people around you who need you, there are so many needs just immediately around you. If you're not seeing to that, then you are neglecting those things. And those are the most practical, most feasible things to see to. I also think loving others, not yourself, is something that grows. So it's something you cultivate, because it's a pattern and a way of thinking. If you're training yourself to only think of yourself, you will become so self-absorbed that you'll just be unpleasant to be around. So if you care about other people more, it'll come more naturally, and you'll gradually be able to take on more and more, while at the same time also looking after yourself. I'm not saying I'm a saint at all. I mean, I love to indulge myself. Don't get me wrong. I'm still figuring out, you know, where does one draw the line, or how should it feature, and what sort of prominence should it have. And I definitely am much more in favor of self-sacrifice, because that is how we build our families, we build our communities and our friendships. And self-love is just going to turn us inwards and make us sad and empty. So there we go. Those are the conclusions I've come to about this. And I'll obviously be talking about some other topics as well coming up soon every Friday. So watch out for my uploads, and remember to subscribe if you enjoy these kind of topics. Goodbye.